back to the Cloud227 Bear Stream. I hope you're all doing well this fine day. I'm doing good. Just continue on with some God of War Ragnarök. Hopefully my audio chat was as good for you as it was for me. But yeah, just leave that on that. And we'll get ourselves ready to go. Quick brush up on whatever mission we're doing. The Reckoning. We continue our mission to free Freya from her curse. If she will not forgive her own brother, what chance is left that she will forgive me? I don't know. But yeah, it's Friday. Just having a casual beer after a day at work. And doing a casual stream.
So they do occupy that time, as I feared.
Ah!
my A game. Yeah, that'll do. Ah, I forgot I can actually up these, can't I? Wait, what am I sure? I have XP, I will have XP for days, I assume. Anyway. Codex. Lore. No. Bestiary. No, it is a beast. A flame grinder. A mount favored by Odin's Einherjar. Likened to lions from Greece, combined with the horns of a goat and antlers of a stag, and the unnatural ability to combust foliage around them. That's fair. Alright. And then Einherjar. Odin's experimentation with Bifrost energy continues to cause trouble, this time in the form of long-ranged bolts shot from Einherjar archers. Not that I'd like to give them credit for anything, but it only makes tactical sense. Imbue the beast, imbue the short-range weapon, imbue the arrows. Though it does present a break with tradition, previously Einherjar manifested their weapons according to their choice in life. Now Odin's removed that limitation from their afterlife. Where do his ambitions cease? Slippery, these archers, either they lose, they close the distance between you quickly, or use your own ranged attacks to fight back.
We need to get to that watchtower. We'll have to go through the valley, this way.
I know your son's story. You should know my daughter's. In the service of a cruel god, I was tricked into destroying a village, not knowing my own wife and child were there until their blood stained my hands. I swore revenge.
That's... I can't imagine.
I paid back their blood 1,000 times and burned Olympus to the ground. Yet, the guilt remained. Perhaps you will kill me, Freya. But it will bring you no peace.
Perhaps it is not peace I seek. All those times I found you, why'd you refuse to fight me?
Every outcome would mean defeat.
What does that mean?
I have never wished you harm, Freya. You helped us. You saved Atreus when he was sick. I did not wish to live with killing you any more than I wished to die.
I see. You hear that? Noken! And so close to the village! Their song makes their allies invulnerable! They will not let you pass unless you destroy them all!
Noken. God. See, dear Noken, this lovely cousin of the humble Noken has discovered the gift of granting boons to its allies during a fight. It relies on the strength of others to keep it safe and out of harm's way. Fascinating how smart these little things have become since they first crawled out of whatever hole they spawned from. Well, damn.
My village. I hardly recognize it. I used to play hide and seek with Freyr in the crops. We'd spend afternoons stealing honey bread from the Grand Hall. At harvest time, we'd dance and feast until the sun rose. It was all so simple. Why did I have to come back here? And be reminded of all this.
A stronger hold!
This guy again.
That guy.
Ah! Yeah!
Scroll chores. Thank you for tending to my home while I am away. I will be sure to bring you a souvenir from Midgard, perhaps an icicle. Haha. Anyway, here's my daily routine. Please follow it as well as you're able. Rise with the sun, whisper to the plants. Any words are fine, although they prefer secrets. feed pigs, mash berries into the feed first, or if the berries have gone sour, I have berry bush seedlings under the bed that can easily mature to fruition with a growth spell. Fetch water from the river, coax bark from the trees for firewood, relax. That's all, I look forward to seeing you upon my return.
It's in ruin.
May Freya never waver.
The other half is missing. May she protect us always. An old adage, if you will.
Freya's people loved her deeply. They seem to have abandoned this village long ago, whether by choice or by force is unclear, but I feel the words have soured in her absence.
I hear them inside. Get ready to clear them out.
Okay, press R2 or R1 at the end of the third swing.
Ah!
I hear them inside. Get ready to clear them out.
That was frustrating, wouldn't you say so?
I hear them inside. Get ready to clear them out. Isn't enough what Odin did to me. He's desecrated every memory I have of home.
Be glad you have a home to remember fondly. In Sparta, we were taken from our homes as children and raised in the Agoi. We marched or we drowned, fought for scraps or starved. Our elders beat us till we could not stand. At night, we made our way home, alone, or were food for wolves. That is how Spartans are made.
Anyone else wanna fuck my day?
These plants behave similarly to the scorn poles we found in the foothills of Midgard ages ago. Considering how Spartans are made, it's no wonder you turned out as you did. Your fate was sealed from the start.
Fate can be overcome.
I used to think so. When the Norns told me of my son's fate, I thought I could change it. You know well how that worked out.
The Norns. The fates of these lands.
That's right. You defy prophecy at your own peril.
Shattering star shield, a shield bathed in radiant light of a thousand dying stars. Force of the cosmos? I finally got a new shield! Double tap L1 to shield punch and blow enemies backwards, increasing power when fully charged. Hold L1 to charge up your shield, blocking an attack, depletes some charge. Shield punch right before an attack hits you and absorb it and gain a burst of charge. Of course I'm doing that. Bitching about my shield all the time. I got a punch shield too. I've missed my punch shield.
Atreus would agree with you about prophecy. He rushes blindly to a fate the giants foretold. Disappears for 2 days, trying to prove he is their champion, fabled to fight at Ragnarok.
What? I know all the Ragnarok prophecies. There's no champion of the giants.
It is one glow concealed. Because of this champion, the realms are saved at Ragnarok. Only Asgard falls, and Odin with it.
So all this time, Odin's obsession with every detail of Ragnarok, he's been missing a crucial piece. Well done, Grower.
Atreus will not be a pawn of prophecy.
You still stand against fate, even with victory foretold.
I will not march my son to war. He is no Spartan. I would keep it that way.
You would speak to me of protecting your child? Is my tragedy not enough of a lesson? Fighting fate is a waste of the precious time we're given to spend with them. You never know when someone will come along and cut it short.
Away to cross the broken bridge.
Go!
Can you swing that torch to the other side and burn the bramble blocking your path? Can you swing that torch to the other side and burn the bramble blocking your path? Use your blades to swing the torch to the other side.
What does it look like, Android?
Let's cross the bridge now. How can you, of anyone alive, be squeamish about war? After all the gods you've killed.
I have seen enough war to know the cost.
And I don't. After the price I paid to end one? Look around you, Kratos. See what happens when you don't fight a true evil.
The gnome chests are full of earring apples and blood and horn meats. Those are perishable, you can't just leave them in there. But the gnomes went through all this trouble to lock them up. You absolutely must open them all post haste while all the tasties are still fresh.
That's one of Odin's captains. Be ready.
Anskotaraskardar. Visa Bandirstaur.
Oh!
That worked out. Glaive, owned by the enhanced and honors with death. Though surface it cannot cut. What does that mean? Glaive of Dunhill. Throw a Bifrost chakram that swerves into enemies. But until then, guys, I'll leave you with a read of who we just murdered with their own scythe. But then we'll take a breaky break. Fisk. What sort must a mortal be to be given such power and authority in Valhalla? To wield a scythe, defend a territory with such vigor, I imagine this Fisk, a farmer who took up arms against some threat and proved adept at slaughter, and for his valor, he was awarded an afterlife of more slaughter. I wonder whether he has a choice. Oh, well, he chose death. So then, guys, thank you very much for watching. Do any likes, follows, comments, subscribes you may wish you want to do now or in the future, and I'll catch you in the next one.